session number 3. Oh, wait. This, I think it's more than session number 3 because I got stuck with the Connor and Marcus chapters, so I had to do some little bit digging to find out where are the points of the scenario to start it. What I mean to say is, it's like a puzzle to find where's the right key. The right time to trigger the scene. So I got stuck with the shade of colors and the partner chapters. Anyway, right now we'll be doing the Kara chapter, which is Stormy Night, and without any more distraction, let's continue. So again, this is probably session number 5 or maybe 6. Probably this is just session number around. Yeah, probably session number 5. Anyway, this is session number 5. We'll be starting in Kara's chapter, Stormy Night. After the loading, let's begin. As I said in a previous session, Kara is gonna be an aggressive version in this story. I wasn't able to do the last time because she died. Alice died, that's why she became just a regular droid. Not an android. But anyway, let's begin. She's been an aggressive person in this chapter. You'll find out what I mean later. Without any more talking, let's continue.
Dinner is ready.
Yeah, I'm coming.
There wasn't much in the kitchen. I did what I could.
Life's funny. I lost my job because of androids. And I need somebody to take care of this goddamn house. What do I do? Go out and hire a fucking android. What a joke.
Let me just check the flow chart. Is there any more? So there's two versions of this. Oh, I missed some parts.
Androids are so fucking wonderful. They never fail. They're never tired. They're never sad. They're so fucking perfect, they ruin my fucking life. What are you looking at? What's your fucking problem? Not the life you dreamed of, eh? Maybe you think this is easy. Maybe you think it's my fault we live in this fucking shithole. My fault your fucking mother took off. You should stop taking drugs, Todd. Sometimes you really scare me, Todd. Fucking bitch took off without a word. Fucking whore walked out on me for a fucking accountant! It's all your fault.
Daddy, no!
It's all your fucking fault! Get back here. Come back here? Come back here right now! I know it's her fault. I gotta teach her.
Oh no.
I gotta teach her a good fucking lesson. That's what you stay there. Don't you dare fucking move, or I'll bust you worse than last time.
let's break the programming. Woo! I'm free! Can't wait to see what she's gonna do next.
Leave her alone.
What the fuck are you doing? Put down the gun and get the fuck out of here. That's an order!
No! I want you to leave her alone.
You want? What do you mean you want? What are you gonna do? You gonna shoot me? Is that it? You gonna shoot a human? You seem to have a problem. I think we need to fix that.
I said!
my. Check the flow chart. So there's two X's at I've been trying the back door. Yeah, I'm gonna repeat this part. Main menu. I wanna see what other scenarios can I unfold. Cause that kinda doesn't change too much, only that Todd died. That's for the back door that this time. Yes, please. Wake up, Kara. Time to wake up. Oh. Ah, sí, me hubiese murido. Tienes que go south. Show on the road.
You took off, not a word. I couldn't hear you. You couldn't have found me. No! Shit about how I felt. Everything. What the fuck are you doing? Put down the gun and get the fuck out of here. That's an order!
No! I want you to leave her alone.
You want? What do you mean you want? What are you gonna do? You gonna shoot me? Is that it? Are you gonna shoot a human? You seem to have a problem. I think we need to fix that.
This is so tense. Okay, and let's try the back door if it's available. I can't do the back door? I guess that's a no-no. Let me take the flowchart again. Go upstairs. That goes upstairs. Take the gun. There's a whole new hidden room here. A hidden scenario. What could it be? You know what, I think I'm gonna have a hold of with the gun for now. I wanna see this part. This hidden part that bit. Go upstairs. Yeah, let's repeat that part. Thank you. exciting stuff. Wake up, Kara. There's three choices for this part. I just can't find out which one to take. Go upstairs. Get to Alice after Todd. I want to see what this third choice. Let's just go straight to the room.
You're coming with me.
Daddy's very mad, Alice. Very mad. It's all her fucking fault.
Ooh, a clean getaway. forgot to ask you for Todd. Oh, so those are just hiding places. It's not really important. Doesn't change the story much. Let's continue. Now for this part, it's just only straightforward. There's only two choices in the end. Check studio with Carl. That's the only difference that I can make there.
That was by far the most boring party I've been to in the last 25 years. Every time I go to one of these, I ask myself, what the hell am I doing here? I hate cocktail parties and all the schmoozers that go there.
Well, it's a chance for all those people who admire your work to meet you.
Yeah. No one gives a damn about art. All they care about is how much money they're going to make out of it. Come on, let's have a drink. Oh, the excitement of this whole thing has made me thirsty.
Scotch, neat as usual?
Absolutely.
Okay, but you know what your doctor would say.
Yeah, well, he can kiss my ass. I'm old enough to choose my own medication. Did you leave the light on in the studio?
No, I'm sure I didn't.
Call the police.
Detroit Police, what's your emergency?
This is Carl Manfred's android at 8941 Lafayette Avenue. We've just returned home and found the lights on. There may have been a break-in.
A patrol car is on the way.
Let's go check it out. Marcus, no, I'm gonna come with you.
Leo.
Oh, look who's here, my father's plastic toy.
Leo. What's going on?
You refuse to help me, so I'm helping myself. It's crazy what some people pay for this shit.
Don't touch them.
Look, they're all gonna be mine sooner or later anyway. Just think of it as a down payment on my inheritance.
Marcus, get him away from there. Get him out of here.
Be reasonable. This isn't gonna get you anywhere.
All you ever do is tell me to go away. What's wrong, Dad? Not good enough for you? Not perfect like this fucking thing?
That's enough! Get out! Right now!
What makes it so special anyway, huh? What's it got that I don't...
Leave him alone!
Come on! Let's see what you got!
Marcus, don't defend yourself, you hear me? Don't do anything.
Go ahead, hit me. What you waiting for? Think you're a man? Act like one.
Stop it!
Does it matter too much of a pussy?
Stop it, Leo! Stop it!
Too scared to fight back, you fucking bitch! Forgot you're not a real person, you're just a fucking piece of plastic!
No, Leo, leave him alone!
I'm gonna destroy you, then it'll just be me and my dad. I'm gonna...
Leo. Oh my God. Leo. My little boy.
Carl, I...
They'll destroy you, Marcus. You gotta go. Get out of here.
Conjure?
Go? I have nowhere to go. Carl, you're all I have.
Get out! Now! Go! Marcus! Don't fucking move!
Too fast that they burnt in this one. Chunk. A lot of things can go wrong here. A lot of things can go wrong. I need to be careful in what choice he's gonna make. He's gonna build a house. What kind of person he thought it would be.
Thank you for using Detroit buses.
Alright. End of line.
End of the line.
Yeah, you're gonna have to leave.
Wake up. We have to go.
Do you know if there's any other place we could spend the night?
I have no idea. She's gonna have to leave.
Find somewhere to spend the night. Come on, Alice, we've got to hurry.
Okay, what's the flow chart? It's like. Can I take here? Top of the park, Android, enter laundromat. Read face to music. Beeline to disaster. Talk to the clerk. Ooh, I don't know where this is going. Where is this thing going? Alright, there's a third choice. No shifts. Okay, let's see. Oh, I stopped at those two first. There's no time limit in this one, right? Yeah. I can go walk by freely for now.
We need a place to stay. Do you know anywhere we could spend the night?
Get us a rock. Organic pizza. Won't open before morning. What, can we spot inside of this place?
Warm in here. You'll feel better in no time.
Not leaving anything behind, huh? Even the hat. Oh wait, that's not a hat. I forgot what that's called, but never mind. What was, what was that? Okay, what's our choices? We could squat or a motel, although we need to steal something or find up some money. Yeah, let's upload charts like the moment. Where are the clothes? Hey, there's a third choice. Check the motel. I gotta know what this one is. Also pass through to this one. The park car. Enter the supermarket. This cash register. Now the scan stack. Check the motel. Okay, let's try that.
A motel. Looks like we found a place to stay. $40 or go somewhere else. Alice, you're freezing cold.
I'm okay. I'm not so cold.
You look lost.
We have nowhere to go.
I know someone who can help you.
But that's on the other side of town. We need a place for tonight.
Come on, Alice.
Thank you for using Detroit buses.
Okay, what would an aggressive person would do in this situation? let's see. Drugstore? No. Check the house. Wait, which house? Oh, that house. Okay.
Look, the store is still open. Maybe we should go inside. At least you'll be out of the cold.
It's gonna be hard. How are you gonna do this? Only can save this part.
Can I help you?
I'm with a little girl and we have nowhere to go. Could you spare some money so we can get a room for tonight?
Look, this is a convenience store, lady, not the Salvation Army. I can't start handing out cash to every bum in the neighborhood.
To him is not a is it even possible? Wait, what's this? Oh, it's her doll. Let me check the flowchart. Maybe there's another way. Can I still talk to him? What am I gonna do? What's this? Oh, cookies. accuse Alice.
You all right? Are you hurt? Well, don't worry. It's just a few cans. They made a lot of noise, that's all.
Come on, let's go.
Fuck!
We have some cash now.
You used me to steal that money. How could you do that? I trusted you.
You're right. I shouldn't have done that. I'm sorry, Alice. I'll never do it again.
Look at the motel.
Hi.
Hi. I'd like a room.
That'll be $40 up front. Just need your name and address. Can I see your driver's license?
I haven't got it with me. Please, the kid is tired.
No worries. We can deal with it tomorrow.
Tomorrow. Oh no.
Have a good night.
Good night. Let's go, Alice.
Do you think he believed you?
I don't know, Alice. All I know is you'll be nice and warm tonight.
Noisy neighbor. This could be a bad thing tomorrow. In the morning.
Give me your coat. Let's get these clothes off. They're soaking wet. I'll just put these in the bathroom to dry.
Right next to the heater.
Why didn't he ever love me? Why was he always so upset with me? All I wanted was a life like other girls. Maybe I did something wrong. Maybe I wasn't good enough. That's why he was always so angry. I just wanted us to be a family. I just wanted him to love me. Why couldn't we just be happy?
I don't know.
You'll never leave me, right? Promise you'll never go.
I promise.
Will we be together forever?
Forever.
I did a bad thing. Stole some cash. Oh yeah. What's this? Yeah, that's not a plan for the third choice, unfortunately. Oh, there's another one. Make a proud. That's the conversation. It's not important. Yeah, where else? Oh, car's tail. Yeah, I can't seem to find the last one. Still gray. What? Discreetly. This adds as a diversion. Oh, so that's what it is. Still discreetly, still clumsy probably or something. Then there's don't use Alice. Probably do some, who knows, if I had the gun, I could just point it at the cash register, the cashier and get the money. Like Bonnie and Clyde would do. Okay, let's continue. Ah, Marcus, you poor bastard.
Hey, diagnosed. Oh.
Your eye's missing. Shot right in the face. As you exited your ear. My, my. Heart's damage. And you have a missing feet. Oh, both of your foot is gone. Oh boy. Yes, he's in foot. Alright. Now we can walk. I believe there's only one path for this one. Let me check the flowchart just to be sure. Yeah, there's only one path. There's only refuse to kill or kill. The two choices of the day. Android begs to die. Find pump. Oh, it's like a. I see. Thank you. Buried alive. Get this ear fixed. It's incompatible. Let's see. What's in the flowchart? Find the pump regulation in Android. 100 begs to die. Now, where is that Android? How about that one? Different version. I don't remember where it's that Andrew that's begging to get and this misery.
Hmm.
Let's try over here. It's just Android. I think I missed my chance. No, that's not it. Forget it. I think I missed my chance to get that scene open. Time to rip this thing off. I couldn't find the android that begs to die. I actually did that before, but I'm sort of in a loss. Probably because I did the repairs first before finding him. Oh man, this is gonna be mad. I didn't find a deviant.
Hello, Amanda.
Hannah, it's good to see you. I expected you to find the deviant who killed that man. I must admit, I'm a little bit disappointed.
I'm sorry. I know I should have succeeded.
Never mind. I'm sure you'll show more foresight in the future. This Lieutenant Anderson has been officially assigned to the deviancy case. What do you make of him?
I think he's irritable and socially challenged. But I also think he used to be a good detective. He's an intriguing character.
Unfortunately, we have no choice but to work with him. What do you think is the best approach?
I will adapt to his personality. It is in the best interest of the investigation that I avoid conflict and try to accommodate his psychology.
More and more androids show signs of deviancy. There are millions in circulation. If they become unstable, the consequences will be disastrous. You're the most advanced prototype CyberLife has ever created. If anyone can figure out what's happening, it's you.
You can count on me, Amanda.
Continue your investigation and put a stop to this. Hurry, Connor. There's little time.
Oh, there's so much to do.
No access without prior authorization. Can I help you?
I'm here to see Lieutenant Anderson.
Do you have authorization?
Yes.
Lieutenant Anderson hasn't arrived yet, but you can wait at his desk.
Oh, the graveyards. If you didn't die in this session, I didn't find the graveyards. Read the famous painting, that's not known. Explore, talk to Gavin. Talk with Gavin. Mm-hmm. Simon Hanks desk. So in this part I guess I'm missing one. What could that be?
Still here? I thought your assignment was over.
It's just been extended.
Hank's gonna be overjoyed to hear that.
You and you come with me.
It's Todd. Is this the case file? No, I thought this was the case file.
Excuse me. Do you know what time Lieutenant Anderson usually arrives?
Depends on where he was the night before. If we're lucky, we'll see him before noon.
Thanks. Call Hank Anderson.
Hi, this is Hank. Not here at the moment. Leave a message if that's what turns you on, but don't expect me to call back. Beep. Whatever.
Lieutenant Anderson, this is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife. It's almost noon, and I'm waiting for you at the office.
He's gonna be pissed off with that after that call. Anderson's younger days when his hair is still short.
It's good to see you again, Lieutenant.
Oh, Jesus. Hank! In my office!
I've got 10 new cases involving androids on my desk every day. We've always had isolated incidents. Old ladies losing their android maids and that kind of crap. But now, we're getting reports of assaults and even homicide, like that guy last night. This isn't just CyberLife's problem anymore. It's now a criminal investigation, and we've got to deal with it before the shit hits the fan. I want you to investigate these cases and see if there's any link.
Why me? Why do I gotta be the one to deal with this shit? I am the least qualified cop in the country to handle this case. I know jack shit about androids, Jeffrey. I can barely change the settings on my own phone.
Everybody's overloaded. I think you're perfectly qualified for this type of investigation.
Bullshit! The truth is, nobody wants to investigate these fucking androids, and you let me hold the bag.
CyberLife sent over this android to help with the investigation. It's a state-of-the-art prototype. It'll act as your partner.
No fucking way. I don't need a partner, and certainly not this plastic prick.
Hank, you are seriously starting to piss me off. You are a police lieutenant. You are supposed to do what I say and shut your goddamn mouth.
You know what my goddamn mouth has to say to you?
Okay. Okay. I'll pretend like I didn't hear that, so I don't have to add any more pages to your disciplinary folder, because it already looks like a fucking novel. This conversation is over.
Jeffrey, Jesus Christ, why are you doing this to me? You know how much I hate these fucking things. Why are you doing this to me?
Listen, I've had just about enough of your bitches. Either you do your job or you hand in your badge. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got work to do.
I would like to start reviewing the case files. Can you tell me where I...
Talk to Hank. Close the door on your way out.
Have a nice day, Captain.
Wait, what's in here? Oh, the restroom.
What? What are you looking at? Hey, fuck you! Fucking android.
Maybe they're smaller. I guess not. He's just sleeping there. Wait for that. Is there any more scenario? He's just sleeping. then there's two choices in there. What is the other one? Maybe it's just a book or something. I don't know. Or maybe the meeting room? Either.
Look at that. It seems Hank has a new partner. Fucking plastic detective. Hey, he was drinking, buddy? You gonna bring him home when he's too drunk to find his car?
Sticks and booze.
Great.
Hello, sure. Detective Reed.
You know, this is where it's just gonna
go. I've never seen an android like you before. What model are you?
RK-800. I'm a prototype.
A prototype? Android detective. So a machine's gonna replace us all. Is that it? Hey, bring me a coffee, dipshit. Get a move on! Do yourself a favor. Stay out of my way.
Ah, poor Connor. He's so naive. This scenario scene. Okay. Missing something here. Can't find what it is. Explore the station. Okay. I need to have to reset this at the checkpoint again. Yeah, I missed one scenario. I have a big feeling it's gonna be that odd person. Might have been too slow getting in the office. That's why it didn't pop up. So at that point, the scenario is finished. If it is not Todd, it might be the android I need to talk to. Soon find out after the load is finished.
Can I help you?
I'm here to see Lieutenant Anderson.
Do you have authorization?
Yes.
Lieutenant Anderson hasn't arrived yet, but you can wait at his desk.
Okay, let's find that desk. Only got part I missed. Quite so fast. See it. Yucks. That's time constraint. God, I hate this. Kind of scenarios. It goes by so fast, you can miss it if you're not careful. Where is it? I knew it was Todd after all. He's the missing link. Time constraint objective is such a bother. One mistake is over.
I'm here to see Lieutenant Anderson.
Do you have authorization?
Yes.
Lieutenant Anderson hasn't arrived yet, but you can wait at his desk.
Okay, need to be fast. Keep missing it. Dang, damn it. Too late again. It's not Todd, let's try the robot on that corner over there.
I'm looking for Lieutenant Anderson's desk.
It's that desk right there.
No, it's not her. What's the missing? Start the scenario and start the scene, start the scenario. Okay. Completed. Let's see. It's not him after all, because this is in the explore the station section. Okay, let's start waiting for him to the station one last time. Let's go to explore the station instead of going inside the office. Might be somewhere in the desk. If that's the desk, maybe somewhere in the hallway. Just to be sure. Explore the station top. Oh, maybe. I think I know what thing. I figured it out, guys.
Can I help you?
I'm here to see Lieutenant Anderson.
Do you have authorization?
But first, let's do this little part.
Lieutenant Anderson hasn't arrived yet, but you can wait at his desk.
Let's see, just if I'm right.
Excuse me. Do you know what time Lieutenant Anderson usually arrives?
Depends on where he was the night before. If we're lucky, we'll see him before noon.
Thanks.
You and you come with me.
Call Hank Anderson.
Hi, this is Hank. Not here at the moment. You can leave a message if that's what turns you on, but don't expect me to call back. Beep. Whatever.
Lieutenant Anderson, this is Connor. I'm the android sent by CyberLife. It's almost noon, and I'm waiting for you at the office.
Jimmy's bar.
It's good there to see you again, Lieutenant.
Oh, Jesus.
Hank! In my office! I've got 10 new cases involving androids on my desk every day. We've always had isolated incidents. Old ladies losing their android maids and that kind of crap. But now, we're getting reports of assaults and even homicide, like that guy last night. This isn't just CyberLife's problem anymore. It's now a criminal investigation, and we've got to deal with it before the shit hits the fan. I want you to investigate these cases and see if there's any link.
Why me? Why do I gotta be the one to deal with this shit? I am the least qualified cop in the country to handle this case. I know jack shit about androids, Jeffrey. I can barely change the settings on my own phone.
Everybody's overloaded. I think you're perfectly qualified for this type of investigation.
Bullshit! The truth is, nobody wants to investigate these fucking androids, and you left me holding the bag.
CyberLife sent over this android to help with the investigation. It's a state-of-the-art prototype. It'll act as your partner.
No fucking way! I don't need a partner, and certainly not this plastic prick!
Hank, you are seriously starting to piss me off! You are a police lieutenant! You are supposed to do what I say, and shut your goddamn mouth!
You know what my goddamn mouth has to say to you?
Okay, okay. I'll pretend like I didn't hear that, so I don't have to add any more pages to your disciplinary folder, because it already looks like a fucking novel! This conversation is over!
Jeffrey, Jesus Christ, why are you doing this to me? You know how much I hate these fucking things. Why are you doing this to me?
Listen, I've had just about enough of your bitches. Either you do your job or you hand in your badge. Now, if you'll excuse me, I've got work to do.
I'm very pleased to have joined the team. I can assure you, I'll do my very best.
Close the door on your way out.
Have a nice day, Captain.
Doesn't care. If I'm right, it's gonna just ignore the guy. If I'm wrong, oh well. What can you do?
Look at that. It seems Hank has a new partner. Fucking plastic detective. Hey, he was drinking, buddy? You gonna bring him home when he's too drunk to find his car? Let's take some booze. Never seen an android like you before.
Ah, it's still not it.
No. The asshole, I'm talking to you. Hey, bring me a coffee, dipshit.
And
get a move on!
Ignore.
I gave you an order.
I'm sorry. But I only take orders from Lieutenant Anderson.
Oh.
That's gotta hurt.
When a human gives you an order, you obey. Got it? Stay out of my way. Next time, you won't get off so easy.
Let's see. That's not it either. Okay, let's keep going exploring the place.
Detroit police found the body of 30-year-old Carlos Ortiz in his home last night, following calls from concerned neighbors. Known to the police as a petty criminal, Mr. Ortiz is reported to have suffered from a psychiatric condition and rarely left his apartment. He is thought to have died several weeks ago. The police are conducting forensic tests, but appear to be treating the death as a homicide. The victim's android is also reported missing. We'll bring you more on that story as it develops.
The first book written by an artificial intelligence has just been published, and to call it a success would be an understatement. Do Humans Dream of Mammalian Sheep has shot to the top of the bestseller list. Moreover, critics are unanimous in their praise for the depth of thought and originality of this first work. Designed by CyberLife, the AI known as Voltaire analyzed human centers of interest on social networks for several months before its complex algorithms generated the plot of the novel. According to several specialists, it will be very difficult for human authors to compete with these algorithms, and the odds are that most of the books written in the coming years will be the work of artificial intelligence.
Hmm. They got it right? Still a no-no. Dang, where's that secret? Where's that secret scene? Maybe because I didn't got the deviant android in the first scenario. Okay, never mind.
I'm sorry I bothered you at the bar last night, Lieutenant. I guess I ruined your evening. In any case, I'd like you to know I'm very happy to be working with you. I'm sure we'll make a great team.
Mm-hmm.
Now that we're partners, it would be great to get to know each other better. Is there a desk anywhere I could use?
No one's using that one.
Listen to Knights of the Black Death. I really like that music. It's full of energy.
You listen to heavy metal?
Well, I don't really listen to music as such, but I'd like to. You have a dog, right?
How do you know that?
The dog hairs on your chair. I like dogs. What's your dog's name?
What's it to you? Sumo. I call him Sumo.
Aren't they androids?
A lot of people don't appreciate having androids around. I was wondering, is there any reason in particular you despise me?
There is one.
He can't say it.
Have you known Captain Fowler for long?
Yeah. Too long.
I was wondering, do you always arrive at the office at this time?
I arrive when I arrive. Stop busting my balls, okay?
If you have any files on deviants, I'd like to take a look at them.
Terminal's on your desk. Knock yourself out.
Kara. Unknown series, but it's destroyed.
Two hundred and 43 files. First dates back 9 months. It all started in Detroit and quickly spread across the country. An AX-400 is reported to have assaulted a man last night. That could be a good starting point for our investigation. Ask for this investigation, Lieutenant, but I'm sure you're a professional.
Why don't you go fuck yourself?
I've been assigned this mission, Lieutenant. I didn't come here to wait until you feel like working.
Listen, asshole. If it was up to me, I'd throw the lot of you in a dumpster and set a match to it. So stop pissing me off. But things are gonna get nasty.
Lieutenant, sorry to disturb you. I have some information on the AX-400 that attacked the guy last night. It's been seen in the Ravendale district.
I'm on it.
I couldn't find the the hidden scene. Oh well. Let's continue anyways. I think it's Kara's turn. It's time to wake up, Kara. So cute. Let Alice rest.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to wake you.
So it wasn't a nightmare?
No. No, it wasn't a nightmare. How about a nice warm bath? And then we can go out and try to get you something to eat. What do you say? Okay. I'll run you a bath.
Well, wait a minute. I missed it. What is happening here? I keep missing the smallest detail in the in the environment. Sheesh. Continue, please. Oh my golly. La 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 la.
I'm sorry, I didn't mean to wake you.
So it wasn't a nightmare?
No. No, it wasn't a nightmare. How about a nice warm bath? And then we can go out and try to get you something to eat. What do you say? Okay. I'll run you a bath.
Chart first. Oh, it's hidden.
Pretty like that. You really look like a human now.
Your bath's ready.
Can I go?
Thanks, Michael. I'm joined by Corktown resident Todd Williams, who was violently attacked by his AX-400 around 11 p.m. last night. Todd, can you tell us what happened?
I was having dinner. I was minding my own business. Damn thing jumped on me. Managed to defend myself, but it would have been crazy. I thought it was going to kill me. I fought it off, but it ran away.
Thank you, Todd. Disturbing news for android owners everywhere. Police have launched a search to find the android.
Let's hope they find it fast.
It's not true. He's lying. He's the one who tried to hurt us. What are we gonna do? We have nowhere to go. And the police are looking for us now.
That android yesterday, he gave me an address. He said we could get help there. Could be worth a try. We can't change the past, Alice. But we can decide the future. We're gonna pull through, and soon all this will just be a bad memory. Finish getting ready. I'll go out and find some food for you, and then we can get going.
Lieutenant Anderson, Detroit Police. Looking for a female android robbed a store down the road last night. You seen anything?
An android? No, I don't take androids here.
Have you seen anyone that looks like this?
Fuck. I knew there was something weird about her. She came in last night. She was dressed normal, you know? There was no way I could tell.
Is it still here?
Yeah, probably. Room 28.
Thank you. Ben, yeah, still at the motel. Send some uniforms to cordon off the area.
This is bad.
You wait in the car.
I think it's best if I go with you.
Listen, I'm tired of you talking back to me. You're a machine, so shut the fuck up and do what I say.
All I want is to accomplish my mission. I'm sorry if that upsets you.
You want to see the end of your mission? Stop busting my fucking balls.
Just leave here for him. It's gonna be bad. Oh, here they come. I guess I can go.
It's gone.
Fuck, that's them. Hey, stop! Police!
Which way did it go?
That way. They're headed for the train station.
I can't take that chance.
Now you will get yourself killed. Do not go after him, Connor. That's an order.
Show us our boys. Get out of there. That was crazy. On the run. Also, there's two choices here. I'm guessing the other choice is cars getting killed. Oh my. Hank Oleg. corner to not to go.
Several sources report that CyberLife has provided Detroit police with a prototype detective android. Although police assistant androids have existed for several years now, this would be the first case of an android being authorized to play an active role in criminal investigations. We contacted CyberLife for comment, but no longer.
We are now approaching Ferndale Station. Please take care.
Ferndale Station.